Hey, what's up everybody, my name is TrophyNut and welcome back to Bioshock in our Let's Replay series where we try to delve a bit deeper into this game's amazing story as we did in the previous episode. So we're still at Olympus Heights and we're gonna head towards the apartment building. But I want to talk about a bit about this room. So this is supposed to be some sort of train station. There's tracks here, but I never understood the use of it. Because that thing is clearly a wall. The rails don't go further than this. This is not built on top of it. And it doesn't go further on the other side as well. So I don't really get the use of this room. But hey, details, I suppose. So, who is Atlas? We kinda already know right now, don't we? He's that bastard Frank Fontaine. Okay, so there's clearly a turret on the other side of that. So let's go with Electrobolt. Search a few of the corpses and then go there immediately. Hack this lovely thing. And take care of these corpses. Okay. So what the code yellow actually does for us in practice is that we're going to lose a bit of our maximum health every now and again. Well, because there has to be some negative effect to that, right? As you can see, it has grown a bit smaller. No. Oh, yeah, there we go. Another bit.
That's it, kid. You're busto. My new friends will catch up with you soon. Kid. I hope they make it quick.
His new friends, of course, being the entire splicer population of this area. There we go, another turret for us. Because, of course, that machine at the end where we put the genetic key in just took over the splicers. That's the machine that creates the pheromones that causes the splicers to follow, the guy that holds the genetic key, actually. So that's actually the key to the city, if you want to call it like that. Let's see what's new in the Gatherer's Garden. We can't buy any more combat salt since we put that to full. So let's buy another. I like Incinerate 3. Repeated use increases heat. The tonics are not really useful to me. So let's see. I'm gonna go with a physical tonic slot just to start it off. Since we like whacking on everything. Let's go with natural camouflage is also a really interesting one which I haven't shown yet. So let's take natural camouflage because it's really cool. Let's upgrade our health as well. There we go. Extra plasma salt. I'm going to buy that eventually, but not right now. Let's just take Incinerate 3. There we go. And now we have a blue flame. And as you can see, now that we're standing still, we can still look around. We become transparent and invisible to other enemies. And we don't actually need to stand still for that long, as you can see. 3, 2. So there's barely 2 seconds that we need to stand still. We're gonna also use the camera a bit more here, because there's a few that we haven't researched yet. Kind of these nitro splicers. So that's, there we go. Permanent 35% chance that any enemy grenade will be a dud. And let's take another one. And let's whack the guy. Oh, that's not good. Okay, that was wrong. There we go. That's mine. I still think there's a camera, or did he blow up the camera? Yeah, he blew up the camera. Okay. Okay, a lot of stuff is exploding. I'm gonna take a few pictures of this Rosie, because we haven't fully researched Rosie's either. Stand still. Stand still. Thank you. Okay, there we go. Job well done. As you can see, there's a road towards Apollo Square right here. We don't need that just yet. Just gonna take a bit of a look around. There's a bar here in the middle, and I think, yeah, more dollars. Because we're gonna be spending some money in a minute. And Mozart of Genetics. Who would that be? Of course, Suchong.
That's quite the little monster Fontaine's dug up. When she does speak, which is almost a never, her accent is thick and grating. Her hair is filthy, and she seems to wear the same mustard-stained jumper day after day. But I've got to hand it to Frank. Tenenbaum is the old-timer diamond in the rough. No formal training, no experience, but put her in front of a gene sequence and she's Mozart at the harpsichord.
So Su Chung wasn't really a fan of Tenenbaum at the beginning, but he started to appreciate her aptitude for the work. So, let's hack this thing. Let's auto-hack it. There we go. We have pretty much everything, but I'm gonna buy these hack tools. Which is kind of weird, because I'm hacking the thing just to buy more automatic hack tools. But that's not really bad. What is all of this about? Hello, dude. Are you reloading? Down he goes, and he has another automatic hack tool. So let's use this automatic hack tool then to hack D. Ammo Bandido, I think. There's one over here, right? Or did I completely fuck that up? Okay, never mind. Never mind, I thought there was another vending machine around here. I was mistaken. So, let's go to the Mercury Suite, which should hold the apartment of Su Chong himself. And there's another one of these, well, train stations, I suppose. I don't really feel like there's train stations, but... And the music is growing a bit grim. Because I think... Yeah, hello. I'm gonna whack you half to death before you even can do anything. There we go. I think there's another splash over there. Yeah, so let's keep incinerate handy. Hello. And now she jumps into the water. And I think we can do this. There we go. So the bees kind of calls her to not be alerted by us, which is also very funny. Is that another... Is that the same Big Daddy or another one? Yeah, okay, I already took a picture of that one. That's the same one from the center area. I think we can actually enter these cabinets, kind of. I thought we could. Or maybe we can only check out what's inside of there. Because I thought I could. Apparently I'm mistaken. There's probably a few that I can enter and a few that I cannot. Oh, there we go. Okay, so let's use telekinesis to grab that corpse and clear this out of traps. Thank you. There we go. So this is the card we can enter. Let's see here. I thought there should be another audio diary in this thing, but I could be mistaken. Oh, there we go.
I don't like this any more than you do, kid. But you gotta understand where I'm coming from. I got 12 years down here. Big investment. Man can't walk away from a long con like that.
No, indeed he couldn't. So that's why we're gonna have to kill you now, won't we? So let's auto-hack this U event and see if anything else has been added. Nope, only Booze Hound. So let's take Booze Hound. Not gonna use Booze Hound, but... Heat-seeking RPGs. I actually should check how much I need from each. Just gonna buy a few of the interesting ones. Could take the auto-hack. Nothing drops out, so that's a good start. There we go, cigarettes, that's gonna affect our health in a negative way. I hear grenades. Oh, he's right over there. Yeah, okay. So let's take a few pictures of you. Okay, so there's a lot of splices in this place. Let's take telekinesis. Wait for any of them to come along.
Make it start a bit.
Ah, come on. They're gonna kill me if I lose you.
So there we go, and he's burning in the oil slick, so that should kill him off. Yeah, okay, you're stupid as fuck, are you? What the hell is she... Ah, okay, the water. Yeah, there we go. So that was something I wanted to do in the freezer, because the splices go for water if they're on fire and there's water in the neighborhood.
No sign of him. Looks like the whole
gate. Goodbye, dude. Oh, we're gonna just whack you to death. Oh, camera. There we go. Let's hack this thing. Oh, let's buy it out. I mean, cameras are still pretty easily bought out, so... Okay. Mercury sweets. Let's see what we can find out now, shall we? More bandages, thank you. That's the bolt shut down. Nice to know it's here. I thought that sounded like it came from over here, but... That was a lot of fox! I'm just gonna let the Big Daddy take care of this. This guy's dead. Let's take a few pictures of this guy. There we go, increased damage. So that's the max, I think. Yeah, there we go. So the only things we need to do now are researching nitro splices and researching... So let's... oh, I can't even buy this one out. Auto hack it then. So that should activate on that splicer over there. Let's upgrade this. Pistol clip size, pistol damage, machine gun kickback. So now the only one that are only ones that are left are of course the ones we don't really need. But if we can choose, I would go for the machine gun kickback reduction. So that should give us 3 fully upgraded weapons. There we go. So let's reload. And now this guy is gonna still attack us. But I have a few anti-personnel rounds for him. Now, we need to get up there using this elevator to Frankfontein. I think, oh no, maybe, I think it's on to the floor. But there's a key code here, so we can't enter just yet. No, that's true. Nobody invited me. But I don't care. Let's keep it for now. I mean, we don't really need anything. We still need to go to Su Chong's apartment, which is right here. I could take out the Big Daddy already, but I'm not going to. These are elite Rosies, because they have the red tint as well, and they have these kinds of red aureoles above them. So let's go inside.
That Tannenbaum ain't what you think. Florence Nightingale, huh? That'll all come crashing down for you can say... canned tomatoes. I've seen good Bunko, and I've seen great Bunko. But when you walk through Rapture and World War II without even a scratch, you got more than leprechauns watching over you.
So yeah, Frankfontein is boasting about we not being able to succeed, probably. Let's check the refrigerator. Nothing in here. So apparently a lot of people were killed in the kitchen of Su Chong. And this is pretty big for a simple apartment, though. But of course, Su Chong was one of the brightest minds in Rapture, so most of these apartments are actually pretty big. Hello! So the first hit did more because I was undetected by this guy. Did one of them just enter? Okay, yeah, I think one of them did. So let's take a look around here. I don't think there's anything behind the paintings. The blowbuck, not useful, but this, Fontaine's human jukebox.
All those years, we thought we were making progress with our Skinner boxes and our electric shocks. What a waste of time. Until Adam, you can know what...
Ah, for fuck's sake, Frankfontein.
It kills me to turn my fist to you, but business is business. Don't let it get you down. Won't make a difference when this whole place is fish food.
Okay, so let's listen to Su Chong again.
All those years, we thought we were making progress with our Skinner boxes and our electric shocks. What a waste of time. Until Adam, you could no more domesticate a child than a boa constrictor. Fontaine gives Su Chong history for child that he wants to imprint into child's head. Kid not a person. He jukebox, ready to play whatever tune Fontaine wants to hear.
So not a bit of information about ourselves that, Su Chong thinks we're a jukebox. I electrified this water, but apparently... this guy was unfazed by it. Where the fuck is he? I keep hearing him whistle, but... okay, never mind. Clever inventor. Your invent stations truly are a marvel of modern engineering, and now you'll need fewer raw materials to make what you want. It's not witchcraft, it's clever inventor. Well, we don't really need that. We have plenty of supplies, so there we go. Mind control antidote.
Become some kind of boogeyman in Rapture. That myth gives him power. But peel back flim flam and a humbug, he's just another con man. And like all con men, he worries he'll end up on the wrong side of grift. That's why he commissioned a lot of 192. The antidote to the mental control plasmid. Fontaine said I better not tell anybody about the antidote. Not even Tenenbaum. And Su Chong is inclined to listen.
So even Su Chong was afraid of Fontaine.
Always secrets when with Su Chong, always secrets. He must have his lot 192 in his lab near Apollo Square. I once stole a dose and brought it back to my flat on the ground floor, but so they could have taken it back to Fontaine's penthouse for the day. I never knew what lot 192 was for, but Su Chong was doing something in secret. On this, I keep my eye.
So there we go, Tenenbaum leads us towards the lot remedy. Don't want to hit the big daddy here. Oh shit.
Hate to see you this way, kid. Hell, I was there when you were born. You ever have a dog you gotta put down? Breaks your heart.
And I think it just destroyed our rocket turret, so... Kerosene. I think this might be a good idea to just take out the big daddy right here. So there's a splicer over here, though. Hey, that's a nitro splicer! Hello! So let's follow her upstairs, because we're gonna need to go here anyway. Jesus Christ, woman. And that's a dud. There we go, that's the effect of the research. Duds. There is, however, a very interesting room across from Su Chong, because you might recognize that music coming from Sander Cohen's apartment. So let's head in here first.
I hear your wings flapping in my home. Flip, flap, flip, flap, flip, flap. Come into the light, little moth. Come in.
There we go. In the man, in the apartment of the man himself. Hello. So there's a couple dancing here. So to the music of the same musical piece that Fitzpatrick was trying to play on that dynamite piano. But we can do something very cool in this room. Hello! And of course, he tells us to not rattle their rhythm. I'm wondering if a grenade in between of them rattles their rhythm. There we go.
When will you ever learn to take instruction? I'm coming down there, little moth. Coming down to teach you to dance.
And that is the effect of antagonizing Sander Cohen, because he comes down from his personal room, which should be over there. I don't know where he is, though. Sander? Sander? I can hear your footsteps.
I'm Sander fucking Cohen!
Yeah, that's right. Okay. So Sander Cohen is a Houdini splicer. So hello! And he's a very, very strong Houdini splicer. So I think I'm gonna go with the exploding buck as well. As we do extra damage with fire. There we go. And now, there's two things we can do in here. One is a very, very cool trophy called the Irony Trophy. And for the Irony Trophy, we need to take a picture of Sander Cohen's corpse, which is, of course, what he had us do in Fort Frolic to his former apprentices. There we go. And that should give us the irony trophy. I think. Yeah, there we go. Irony. And there we have $65, 39 anti-personnel rounds, and Cohen's Muse Key, which actually opens the box that we couldn't open in Fort Frolic, which I might return to when we can. So we can also enter this place, which is Sander Cohen's personal room. And that's another trophy found, Cohen's room. So you can only get both of these trophies when you wait to kill Sander Cohen until you get to his apartment. Because his apartment is locked if he's not around to open the door. And there is, of course, another power to the people station here. I think I'm going to go with crossbow breakage chance. Yeah, it doesn't really matter at this point. We're going to have... I think we should have all of them when we are done. So 4 fully upgraded weapons. And more of those plaster statues next to his bed for some reason. I wouldn't want to sleep with 2 of these next to my bed. And of course more Moonbeam Absinthe, which is his favorite drink. I think there's also an audio diary around here somewhere. I just need to find it, right? Machine gun rounds. More crafting materials. And a buttload of Moonbeam Absinthe. Is there an audio diary? There's something in the bathroom. More first aid kits, we can use that. And a, yeah, lovely little guy on the toilet. Let's use the toilet. Okay, I thought there was another audio diary here, but apparently there isn't. They might have not wanted to lock too many collectible achievements behind this room. Well, trophies, why the hell did I say achievements? Trophies! Trophies, because I don't think there's anything in the bed. Can't even get on the bed. No. Okay, that's that. That is Cohen's personal room.
Ryan's flesh and blood. Why'd I go to the trouble? Otherwise, you'd have been cut in two by the first security bot you crossed paths with. But not Ryan. He made it so his security would recognize his genetic structure. With half his genes, you ain't immune. You got just enough to throw their metallic nukes off their game.
So that's why the turrets don't always immediately recognize us, and the cameras as well, because they're also tailored to his genetic, to Andrew Ryan's genetic makeup, making us the perfect candidate for Fontaine's little evil plan. There's a few more things in here. I think, yeah, the safe. Oh no, it's not a safe. It's a steamer trunk. Okay, so that's the room of Sander Cohen. There's 2 more areas to the left and to the right here. Well, 1 to the left and 1 to the right. Another dead cat. I really don't know what's up with Rapture and dead cats, but they really seem to like that. I do need to hurry, because these periodic health nips are going to kill me if I don't hurry up. You? Are these guys? Yeah. They think so. It looked like you still had some spark in you, quite literally. Let's take a look around. More cream-filled cake and nothing else, apparently. So useless, except, of course, for the lovely room up there. I think we will be returning here. If we don't for the quest, then I will do that myself anyway. Because there are more very interesting rooms in here as well. Because this is the room of Anna Culpepper. Sander Cohen's rifle, right next to Sander Cohen's apartment itself. But let's go first to Apollo Square in an attempt to finding the cure, the antidote. So back in the center area, and we're gonna head towards Apollo Square. I don't know why the arrow points me to the other direction. What is all that about? Oh, never mind. Yeah, of course, Tenenbaum also has a pop of lot 192 in her apartment. So let's quickly go there then first. Kind of fucked up there. Never mind. So back in here. And it should be on the second floor. So let's go up the stairs. And I won't forget the other rooms. Because there's another floor up there I think we can access. There's also another camera. I think we could hear it. Yeah, it's up there. Gonna make it a bit harder. But here's Tenenbaum's apartment, which is locked. Huh. I can't seem to remember how we get in there then. Maybe from the apartment next to it? This woman is dead. This is open. There we go, that guy down. I never actually checked above the door which apartment is this. I don't remember all of them. But this is scratched out for some reason, probably because they didn't have any characters here. So again, a complete family just murdered here. Two little sisters and father and mother. So yeah, we're gonna be pretty full up on everything. Let's check out this room. Maybe we can cross over in one of the other apartments from here. Not exactly sure. The kitchen is on fire. This is not good. There's a screw here. Let's use the sink. Nope. Not gonna help us in any way. Let's open this room and yeah, let's take one of those bodies. Preferably not one of those little sisters, please. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, okay. There we go. First aid kit we can't use. Ooh, look at that. Camera, more film. And Eve hypos we can't really use. Well, I'm guessing it's something at least. So that's about it for this apartment, I think. Oh, there we go again.
Adam's the ultimate score, kid. No more grifts, no more scams. A monopoly on Adam makes Standard Oil look like the Piggly Wiggly. All that's left is burying the bodies. And when they're already 6 miles under the Atlantic, you've got one hell of a head start.
Yeah, thank you. Oh. It's not what I wanted to do, but you know what? I don't really like cameras anyway. Oh, shit. Seriously, that 5 seconds? I should drop... Oh! Jesus, these things are strong. I think there's... Yeah, okay, here's the bolt shut down, so let's use that. That was a bit silly. So now we're at the top floor. We can't go any higher. This is the camera we destroyed. There seems to be a splicer right over there. Can I pop him in the head from here? Yeah, we can. Jump and shoot the man in the face. Let's go. So I think we can access Tannenbaum's apartment by dropping down from this one. Whoa. Yeah, a complete mag of anti-personnel pistol rounds is needed to kill that one. And we have another audio diary, Fontaine's breakup.
Looks like things have gone busto between Fontaine and his little German beanpole. Why a guy like Fontaine would waste his time with that spooky crowd when he could be getting the gravy from any dish he chooses is beyond the understanding of this paparazzi. Even reset the door code to 5744. Maybe to be double sure that beanpole don't sprout up in his yard again.
So with that, we have the door code to the elevator that leads up to Fontaine's personal apartment. But we're gonna first enter this apartment, which should allow us to drop down onto Tannenbaum's. Okay. So that was a dud. I have a feeling that the dud thingy is actually more powerful than 35%. Let's see. There we go.
Who is an amateur? Fucking amateur!
I'm an amateur. I'm really good at taking pictures, though. Are you going anywhere? You're going any- Oh, for fuck's sake. Seriously? Where's the other one? I heard the other one. There's two natural splices in this place. We just researched- Oh, no. She isn't. Are you? I don't think you are. Because I just whacked you to death. So let's see. We can drop down right over here. Although we did just come from here. Yeah, okay. So we're going to have to find another hole for that. Let's see. A dead guy in completely... The apartment upstairs apparently collapsed and the bathtub fell down. Weird. Is there anything else in here? Because, of course, the further we get into the game, the harder it is for me to remember the rooms. You always remember the rooms at the beginning of a game better than after that. There's another room back here. Ooh. And that guy got shot with a Tommy gun. Jesus. That was heavy. Whoa. So just keep circling around this guy. Bandages, coffee, nothing else apparently. So just a douchebag. A guy that tried to ambush me. Let's go back out, because I do want to get to Tenenbaum's apartment to end this part. Let's see. There is another hole over there. Okay, yeah, Can't I return back? Maybe over here? Yeah, okay. Because there's another hole in the wall right over there, I think. There's one over here, apparently. Frag grenades. Not of use to me. Oh yeah, over there. Yeah, okay, so I need to go... What's with the clicking? Okay. Something exploded. So the guy that was over here, I popped him in the head already. So that should allow us to get inside of the apartment. There we go, don't really need that. Let's check out the rest of the apartment. I think this should be the place where we can drop down onto Tenenbaum's apartment. Okay, the television is going static. Anything behind the painting? No. This one is not dead either, is he? Is she? Oh, there's a staircase over here. Goodbye, and it's marked whore. Which is, of course, I think we're already inside of Tenenbaum's apartment then.
Look at my home, torn apart by Fontaine and his pigs. No doubt he had the samples of Lot 192 taken to his penthouse. Entrance is in lobby, but the damn thing is always locked. You will not believe me, but there was a time when this place was also beautiful.
So Lot 192 is, of course, missing from this place, which is sad. Really sad. So let's take the money and just leave her apartment as it is, because I don't think there's much in the upper floor here. So let's go down and go out through the door that was locked.
What do you take me for? Some kind of mental incompetent? We tossed Mother Goose's roost the moment she decided to grow a conscience. You won't find nothing here, kid. Except maybe her memories. And trust me on this, you don't want them.
So yeah, Fontaine confirming what Tenenbaum said, that he removed the cure towards his penthouse. Well, luckily enough, we have the code to his penthouse now, so let's unlock the elevator. Let's whack this thing off. Yeah, now you're firing at a big daddy. I don't think that will turn out great. Seriously, you're not gonna attack? Oh shit, I attacked the little sister. That's a problem. That's a problem. Let's hide. And that should end him. Holy shit, that was not supposed to happen. Well, I'm gonna rescue you anyway. Should be our third one again, I think. Schwa? There's only two in this area, by the way.
Adam improved every aspect of man except his character. Perhaps there is a plasmid that can grow the spirit. Perhaps in your DNA, the secret life. I sent a little one with some goodies to help ease your burden.
And another dud. So she sent a little one with more goodies. Thank you for that, because I'm going to need that. So now we're gonna head back down and open the elevator, which should allow us to head back into, well, up there. Ow.
You think you're some kind of hero? I ordered you up from Suchong like a Chinese dinner. A little from column A, a little from column B. What do you plan on going back to? Your fake family? Your phony dreams? Putting you out of your misery will be the nicest thing anyone's ever done for you.
So, let's enter the code after he's done babbling and threatening us. So I think it was 5744. There we go. And, well, I couldn't end the episode without us getting cured, right? So let's go up. Gonna be a bit of a longer episode, but I don't care at the moment.
My life is to save the world entire. I made a place for the children here, but it is you who are their savior. Will you stop here? Or will you deliver them from this terrible city at long last?
So there's a camera in this place somewhere. Yeah, over there.
Huh? I'm on to you!
Don't know where the camera is. Oh, there it is. Ah, shit. This is gonna be a problem. Shit. I went around this place the wrong way. Is there a bolt shutdown in this area? Yeah, there is. Attack this thing. Oh, why am I... Oh, shit. That's a problem. That's definitely a problem. Of course, forgot to take out the camera. No. No, you shall not. Fuck you. Stupid cameras. So, I think we killed a few splicers. Nothing too crazy. Let's keep Electrobolt handy. I'm gonna keep it loaded. Just in case there are more turrets in this place. Which there could be, of course.
I'm gonna miss this place. Rapture was a candy store for a guy like me. Guys who thought they knew it all. Dames who thought they'd seen it all. Give me a smart mark over a dumb one every time.
Yes, indeed. You're gonna really miss this place once I kill you. Rubber hose. Who keeps a rubber hose in a fridge? Seriously. I'm gonna try and take out the fucking music over here. Where are you, music? Where are you? Where are you? I wanna stop you from singing. Because I don't want this video to be copyrighted. Where is it? The music is coming from nowhere, isn't it? It's coming from over here. Stop it. Stop it. Yeah, okay. I'm just going to have to talk over it constantly. Let's auto-hack this save. Giving us a bit more stuff. More Eve hypos, apparently. And I think there are a few more audio diaries in this place. There should be, either way. File cabinets. Ooh, that's nice. Old Tom Whiskey. Don't need that. So let's go in here then. There should be another room here, and this is where Lot 192 should be. Can I use telekinesis to grab that thing? Seriously? That's one. Oh, for fuck's sake, thank you. So that's Electric Flesh 2, which is, of course, amazing. Let's upgrade that already. Tonic collector, there we go. I think that's for 46 tonics to collect that. Lot 192, pick it up. And we got our health back. And now we have another problem.
The compound is taking off. The effects of the mental suggestion are now gone. But there will certainly be side effects.
Yeah. Because the main side effect is that my plasmids have become unstable. And I'm temporarily unable to choose which one I have equipped. So there we go. I just have security bullseye right now. There we go. So that forces us to go to Apollo Square either way.
Now go find Su Chang's lab in Artemis Suite. In there, no doubt there will be more of this lot 192.
Indeed there will be. So every time this happens, I get another plasmid. So this is Winterblast, by the way. God damn it. There we go. Oh, he still drops a grenade though. So let's heal up. We still have everything now. We have everything back. I mean, our health bar is back to what it was before.
No way! Don't you disrespect me!
There we go. Do you have any health kits? I need health kits. Seriously. So, with lot 192 in our possession, we should... I'm wondering, is there anything else in this area? There we go, it's target dummy. Don't really need target dummy. I don't think there is. I think that's in the second game, without spoiling too much, that there's another area here, but hey. Okay, so I'm gonna take a little break right here on Fontaine's apartment, so thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And next time we're gonna try and get rid of our unstable plasmids, because not being able to select the correct plasmid can bite us in the ass quite a bit. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!